Greetings! Welcome to the Elec Plays First Impressions, a series where I give you my first impressions on video games. In this premiere episode of First Impressions, I'll be taking a look at New Star Grand Prix, developed by New Star Games. New Star Grand Prix will be available on March 7th, 2024 for PlayStation 4, Xbox Series, Nintendo Switch, and Steam PC. I would like to thank Danielle at Outrageous for providing me a copy of New Star Grand Prix. New Star Grand Prix is a fast, fun, and addictive arcade racing game with an authentic early 90s polygonal visual style. It harkens back to my childhood days playing racing games like Yu Suzuki's Virtua Racing on the Sega 32X, and the arcade classic Ace Driver by Namco. The racetracks, the cars, and the landscapes are beautifully rendered in flat-shaded polygonal visuals. New Star Grand Prix runs at a consistent 60 frames per second on all platforms, including the Nintendo Switch. New Star Grand Prix is all about strategy, and you'll be applying your own racing strategies in the game's two main modes, Career and Championship. Championship is a single-player mode and a multiplayer split-screen mode of up to four players. I personally recommend playing Championship mode first so you can familiarize yourself with the circuit and the controls of the game. Championship mode offers a lot of freedom and flexibility. You can play the way you want and how you want. You can select any car from any racing decade from the 80s to the 2020s. The teams and the cars you select are purely cosmetic choices that have no effect on performance during races. In championship mode, you'll compete in cup competitions to be the ultimate driver. Each cup competition is set over a number of races. The winner of the cup will be determined by the driver who has accumulated the most championship points. You can create your very own cup competition, set up your own rules with a plethora of options to choose from. Career mode incorporates the best elements of a role-playing game and the exciting gameplay of a classic arcade racing game. You'll start your racing career in the 1980s. Over the course of five decades, you'll race in 176 events, with 34 tracks to master in 17 locations around the world. Career mode is the main single-player mode, and there are six types of events. Grand Prix is a classic racing format set over six laps. You'll begin the race in the last position, and you must finish the race in a qualifying position to advance to the next event. In Grand Prix, fuel is gradually depleting, real-time car damage is activated, and tires wear out, so you'll have to make at least one pit stop during the race. Reverse races are similar to the main Grand Prix, but the racetracks are in reverse. Elimination is one of my personal favorite events. You'll begin the race in the last position, and every 30 seconds, the car in last place is eliminated. You gotta drive to survive. In time trials, you must finish the required number of laps within the set time limit. A checkpoint race begins with an amount of time on the clock that counts down as soon as your car crosses the start line. Passing through a checkpoint adds time to the clock, and your goal is to complete the required number of laps before the time on the clock runs out. Sometimes you'll be challenged to a one-on-one rival race against a driver from a previous event. Win the rival race and prove your superiority. In career mode, it's important to keep your team happy and upgrade your car as you compete with the other drivers through the five decades of racing. Managing resources and making decisions that affect your racing career is a strategic element that I really like. You can prioritize staff perks or prioritize car upgrades. Staff perks offer bonuses like reducing the amount of time spent at the pit stop, greater chances of starting off the race at maximum speed, and gaining a speed boost by aligning your car right behind an opponent's car. The cars in New Star Grand Prix have incredibly satisfying handling. I personally like the 2010 cars. They strike the right balance between speed and control. New Star Grand Prix may look like a simple arcade racing game on the surface, but there's an incredible amount of depth. Timing and execution can influence the outcome of a race, and in order to win, you need to apply your own race strategy. Fuel management is paramount. It's important to have a balanced fuel load to optimize the car's performance, because a full tank will make the car heavier to drive. That being said, running out of fuel during a race can be catastrophic. If your car runs out of fuel, it will gradually slow down to a crawl. Choosing the right tires can make all the difference in achieving victory on the track. There are three types of tires: soft tires, hard tires, and wet weather tires. All three tires have distinct characteristics, unique benefits, and drawbacks. Tires degrade naturally as you drive around the track, but the rate of degradation will depend on how you drive. If you drive off the track recklessly or make sudden severe breaks, the rate of degradation will increase exponentially. New Star Grand Prix features a dynamic weather system. Weather changes can affect races, and if you have the wrong tires equipped, that can be problematic. If it starts raining, drive to the pit stop, change your tires to wet weather tires, and refuel the car. If the car is running low on fuel, or if any of the car's components are critically damaged, you need to make a pit stop. The strategy here is deciding when to visit the pit stop. In Grand Prix, my initial goal is to overtake all the other drivers, set the fastest lap time, and make a pit stop in the third lap. I'm basically creating a time gap between myself and the other drivers with worn-out tires. If I'm successful, I'll be ahead of the other drivers while they make their pit stop. Every track has a perfect line for maximum speed. The quickest path on the racetrack is indicated with a racing line. Go full throttle when the racing line is green. Release the accelerator when the line is yellow. And when it's red, hit the brakes. The turbo boost regenerates every time you cross the start line. Using a turbo boost when your car is near its top speed will allow it to go past its limit. Collisions with other drivers, barriers, and driving off the track will damage your car. The state of the car's components is displayed on the right side of the screen. If any of the car's components are critically damaged, the handling and speed of the car will be negatively impacted. In most race events, you're given three rewinds. If you make a mistake, you can go back in time to a point of your choosing and drive a section over again. Some race events offer extra rewards for not using any rewinds. So if you're a completionist, you may want to stave off using rewinds. Colliding with the other drivers will make them more aggressive and difficult to overtake. Sometimes you'll notice their emojis during a race, which define their behaviors on the track. If you anger the other drivers, they will be motivated to drive more quickly when close to you, and they will find other ways to sabotage your efforts in winning the race. So don't be a jerk. New Star Grand Prix provides all the excitement of a real-life motorsport inspired by many arcade racing games of the early 90s. There's nothing more satisfying than winning a race with the right strategy. I've won all the cup competitions, and I'm making good progress in my career. I'm really looking forward to seeing what's next for New Star Grand Prix and New Star Games. Thanks for watching this premiere episode of First Impressions. See you next time.